Nicolas Maduro said he had jail cells ready for his enemies after Sunday's vote. Now he has filled two of them. 62-year-old Antonio Ledezma was still in his pajamas when masked security forces entered his home after midnight. He briefly tried to resist as his daughter screamed, "Dictatorship." Both Ledezma and Leopoldo Lopez are former mayors of Caracas. Both were under house arrest, and both called for opposition to Maduro's plan to rewrite the Constitution. Now both are in military prison. The arrests come in the wake of Sunday's street protests, which left 10 dead. The U.S., the European Union, and a host of Latin American nations condemned the vote as an attempt to create a one-party state. The U.S. has gone a step further, initiating sanctions against Maduro personally, putting him on par with the rulers of Syria, North Korea, and Zimbabwe.
Maduro is not just a bad leader, he is now a dictator. The United States stands with the people of Venezuela in the face of this oppression.
Maduro has shown no inclination to compromise with the protesters or the U.S., responding with mockery.
I don't take orders from the empire. Bring on more sanctions, Donald Trump.
The sanctions against Maduro are largely symbolic. Sanctions against oil exports could devastate Venezuela's economy, but are risky. Oil sanctions against Venezuela could raise the price of gasoline in the U.S. and create thousands of Venezuelan refugees. Brett?
Steve Harrigan in Miami. Steve, thank you. We will follow up that story daily. Next up.